it forced the public to have a conversation, not only about like guns and gun regulations, but also about you know, art itself and where the line is, what should be edited and what shouldn't be edited, and you know, and I feel like, you know, in terms of pushing the envelope of culture and forcing people to have those conversations, I think that it was you know, a really healthy thing for my country. I wrote Pumped Up Kicks when I was at work. I was a composer for a company called Mophonics in Venice Beach. And so I had my own little studio there, and when I wasn't working on ads or commercials or television, I would write songs for my own project. I think, you know, in terms of the lyrical content, you know, I wrote the chorus first, and it was kind of an interesting defining moment for that song, actually, because the chorus, without the verses give a different context to the chorus. The chorus by itself, before the verses were written, was really, it was really kind of a confidence song. All the other kids better run from my gun, but gun, at that point, was just a metaphor. It wasn't a literal thing. At least the whole first verse was just a freestyle. The recording and the lyric, it just kind of came out at once. And that's when I kind of knew that the song was actually about a kid, and that it was actually that gun in the chorus was actually a literal thing. You know what? Yeah, it did surprise me that the song took off, because when the song started to break, just on blogs and it started to catch some real traction, I remember just walking into rehearsal with my band with my hands on my head, just saying, I can't believe that this is the first song that people are gonna hear from us. You know, because to me, I knew that I was gonna have to answer 10,000 interviews about what the song is about. I was proud of the song for a few reasons, you know. One, that it was a left of center, like, pretty bizarre song that ended up climbing the charts in top 40 radio, which helped kind of open up top 40 radio a little bit in the States, and you know, to actually have a band, a guitar, God forbid, to have a guitar, an electric guitar, and a song on top 40 radio. But also that it became a topic that people talked about, because I felt like it was a really important conversation to have. If I would have known that song was gonna be played everywhere, I would have taken those damn choruses out of the song and I would have made it fucking move faster. You know, because like by the end of it, it was just like chorus, 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 chorus. I was like, this is driving me crazy. Hear this stupid chorus again. So I would have changed that, you know. I heard the Weezer and the ASAP Rocky cover. Yeah, it's cool, man. You know, I like both those artists. You know, with Weezer especially, it was cool because I met Rivers Cuomo 10 years ago when I first moved to LA. And I remember I had just started writing songs. I had just started trying to write songs. I didn't even sing and play guitar at the same time back then. I remember playing him an instrumental song that I wrote on my guitar at a party, and he politely listened to it and then taught me how to play Say It Ain't So. And so for him, 10 years later, to cover a song that I wrote was a pretty big moment for me.